Because he said.
Yeah. Oh, I appreciate it. Thank you. Mike DeLore was a good dude, man. He works hard. I owe you. So first of all, huge weekend for you. You have two fights. You have Victor Ortiz up the street, and then you have Tim Bragg. Tell me about those two fights this weekend.
Well, everything is manageable. You know, coming into the fight, I knew that I had a busy schedule. That's the reason why I put a team together like I've always had. You know, one person usually gets all the credit, but it's not one person that does the whole job. We have a team. I have my brother, I have Jose, and my brothers are there, you know, in training camp with me. I trained a team for years so they could train like me, and they're always under my command. We're always communicating with each other, and everything rolls well, and every fighter knows that we work the same. So, you know, when I got the call from Al Heyman and said, hey, you know what, we got Victor fighting the same day, different venue, but we know that priority is Bradley because he had his date, and sure. So they gave me the time. Okay, Victor's going to be fighting on Showtime Extreme early. It gives you plenty of time for you to be with Bradley. At the same time, you know, Bradley along, you know, his father, James, and then Jackson, they're always with him. So all I have to do is, the work is done. The work is done already. We leave the work behind. In the gym, we put in the work. Now we come here just to break a couple pounds and make the weight and just fight. So as long as I'm in the dressing room with them and I bring them to the ring and guide them to a victory, it's all that matters.
Tim Bradley's one of the best fighters in the world. He already fought Pacquiao, beat him once, fought Marquez, beat him. If he takes care of Diego Chavez, who would you want him to fight next?
You know, unfortunately, we've never had that privilege, you know, that we always pick. Tim Bradley has been in a winning streak, you know, through his career. But it's always who they give him. It's not who he wants. Of course, you know, we would like the best fights possible. In the boxing business, we want to see the best fights, you know. But you know, next year, Tim Bradley is open to anybody. Anybody at 147 that can be workable, because you know sometimes there's issues with promoters and they.